Oh, thank you, Father. Just lay hands on Graham and his work out in the West in Camden. Thank you, Father, for that church, Lord. We thank you, Father, for whatever you got in the future for them, Lord. We just release life to the whole community out in Camden Way, Lord. We just thank you for new springs of life, new awakenings, new visitations, Father, that there'll be a whole new structure, a new wineskin. We just thank you for a new wineskin for the wine. Thank you for a new wineskin for the wine. Whoa! Shaman de se kiki tisa kaba ha ba 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 keke se te huko kutu kuku kupura. Preza la kitikila. Shaman alaba sebe. Thank you, Father. 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 There we go. Thank you, Lord. 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 That's what midwives sound like. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Ho! Holy. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father, for testimonies and reports from these outer regions and country towns, Lord. Thank you for we'll see an increasing number of reports coming back. I was baptizing four new Christians last Sunday down at Bronte, and there'd been an Aboriginal couple visiting us from Surrey Hills, and as I chatted to this man after the service, he began to tell me stories from the 80s of 2,000 Aboriginal people baptized in one day, in some river, in concrete somewhere. It sounds a strange name, but it's a real place. And it was on National 9 News. It was so amazing that they did a documentary on it. It was on one of the major programs. And other things he's seen, the Holy Spirit falling on people under the trees, and just the glory of God and angels of the Lord appearing and preventing people from coming through until they repent, and hundreds of people getting saved in a day. And he was just saying that it feels like a fallow period for a long time. And he said now he feels the time for those reawakenings. And he's got young people, young men that have a heart for their own nation. They're young in their 20s, and now they're ready to run. They've got fire. They've had their houses burned down. They've lost their cars to being torched because of Christ. And now they're released. They want to run. And so I just thought it's amazing that the sequence of God bringing people together at a time when we can believe and agree with them and stand with them. And the fact that we met Mick, and Mick is half Aboriginal, and all his family are Aboriginal, and he's planting a church, and he's going to be released into this nation.